Hey everybody, Ann here. Well, as I said in the pinned comment on yesterday's video, things went south, and here's what happened. All right, it's almost 6 p.m., and I went out to check on these pretty babies, and Miss Pris was pecking at them. I'm not talking just a peck here, a peck there. She was chasing them around the van and pecking them. And I'm looking them over for any injuries right now. She went after Patty a lot. And Patty looks different. She just came back today. But she pecked at the barred rock. The barred rock has been there from the beginning. So these poor little chickens are stressed out. So I did what I felt needed to be done and brought them all inside. This is too small of a brooder box. It's going to have to do tonight. And I'm going to have to build something else tomorrow. I cannot freaking believe this. I will never let that hen sit on eggs again. Never. Ugh. But I think they're okay. And when I say pecking them, she wasn't just like giving them a little nip here and there. She was really going after them. It was okay for about the first couple of hours that all of the chicks were together. I didn't hear any distress from the chicks. It looked like everything was going great. She was scratching around in the van with them. And then I went over and I kind of looked at her from the back of the van. And she kind of had that, her head up, and she just looked stressed. You know, her beak was open and she was panting a little bit. It wasn't because it was too hot, because it wasn't. And then, a little while after that, I started hearing distress calls from the baby chicks. And so I went and looked and watched, and she was going after all of them. Patty was getting it the worst, and I've read that some broody hens will pick on the little baby chicks that look differently and maybe don't belong to her, which makes sense because she went after the barred rock, too. And I don't understand why all of a sudden, they were 4 weeks old as of yesterday. So I don't understand why all of a sudden she did that unless she was just done and she wanted to get out of the van. So that's what I did. I gathered them all up. I put them in the little box and let them romp around for a little while. And then the heat mat was on underneath of them. And then I put the box on top. They all went in and they slept really well. It was very warm in there. In fact, a couple times they came out because I think maybe it was a little too warm. But it's going to get down in the 40s. Like, I don't know if it's tonight and tomorrow, but it's supposed to be pretty cold. So I couldn't imagine her, you know, Miss Pris, not doing something bad to those chickens and them being left to fend for themselves in the cold. So I brought them inside. And Miss Pris has just gone back to being a regular hen again. She's, you know, she roosted with the other chickens last night in the normal roosting spot. And so, yeah, that's what I did. So let's get to this morning then. Good morning, sweet babies. They had a really good night last night in that little black box that was over the top of them. That I put over the top of them when they sleep with a little hole in it. It stays really warm in there, and the mat's down on the ground. I'm not putting it on top anymore. So that worked really well. And they're all just happy. They're getting along with each other. They're not pecking on Patty because she looks different. Yeah. All right, so today, I literally just got up. I think it's like 5:30. I need to make a bigger brooder box for them. So that's one of my goals. So here they are in the little homemade brooder box made out of cardboard boxes. I made this part a little higher. Yep, lots of duct tape. I didn't get it stuck on very good. And I used the box that the generator came in. And the air conditioner, those are the only two good solid boxes that I had. But I made this a little bit higher because I ended up poking a hole in the sides and just put a little roosting bar in there. yeah, they're doing just fine. They got their food and water. I gave them some scrambled eggs this morning. There's a Bard Rock. But they've all been eating, they've all been drinking, they have not been fighting with each other. I'm sorry I'm shooting through this screen, but they're just doing really, really well. And they're really pretty. But one thing I've noticed is they're 4 weeks old, but they are less matured, less feathered out than all the other chickens that I've had. And I try to think, what is the difference? I think the difference is that I let these go out in free range with mom from a very, very early age, and I just don't think they were getting the proper nutrition. I mean, I still had the grower feed, but if they're out, you know, hunting, pecking, and filling their bellies with, you know, just forageable food, they probably are not getting enough protein. So you may see that they have, like, feathers around their wings, but if you were to watch them flap their wings, their bodies don't have any feathers hardly at all. Patty has the most feathers out of all of them. Bard Rock has quite a few too, right there. But they are definitely less matured here for about a month. I'm going to have to get a bigger box. Because it's starting to get cold. This is not a good time to be breeding chicks. So they need to be raised up until they can tolerate the cold and withstand the pecking order trials and tribulations that will inevitably occur when they are indoctrinated into a flock. And this is what the box looks like from the outside. Now, I did this like at 5:30 in the morning before I had even had my coffee, and I've just got this over the top. And then I will put a blanket over the top of this. Maybe not during the day because it's pretty warm in here right now. But at nighttime I will, just to retain the heat. And they've got their little box over there. And it, I don't know, Donna B., do you remember that box? You filled that box with goodies for me. And it's a really nice box. So I just cut a little door in it and they can go in and out. So it's not ideal, but they're safe. And I get to watch them and it'll be more fun. I figure I will have to keep them, like I said, for another 4 weeks. I'm not sure. It's going into the cold season. I keep saying that. And that's one regret that I have, is that I didn't see enough into the future and plan better for this and not let her hatch out those eggs. I don't think you really want to start hatching out eggs after July. I just don't think it's a good idea. Another decision I've made is that I will not let chickens free range until they're probably a couple months old. So last night I was really angry at Miss Pris. I was mad at her. I mean, I saw a hen that I did not recognize, but I can't be angry with her because I should have known. I should have known. I've made so many mistakes with this last brood. First of all, letting her hatch them out this late in the year, that was my first mistake, not considering that we're going into cold months. My second mistake was letting her take the babies out and free range at such a young age. That was a bad decision as well. I won't do that again. The next bad decision I made is letting them out to free range on that morning when it was going to start raining. I shouldn't have done that. And that caused these chickens a lot of stress, and I lost one as a result. So that won't happen again. Also, well, Miss Pris isn't going to sit on any more eggs this year. Now, I'm not going to let her brood any more chickens because she's kind of proven to be not the most stellar mom. She starts strong, but she quits early. The first brood, she gave up on after 3 weeks. The second brood, 4 weeks, and she just started ignoring them, basically. And they started roosting by themselves, and she just, you know, went and roosted with the rest of the flock. Luckily, those chickens had plenty of feathers, and it was much warmer. And now, this group, she basically gave up at 4 weeks. And really, they need at least a couple more weeks with Mama, maybe 2 to 4 more weeks. So she didn't go the long haul. I don't think she's a long haul chicken mama. She is still a very young hen, but I mean, they're basically a year old. But I'm not going to let her brood any more chickens. I will let her be the incubator. I will let her set on eggs. But I will take the baby chicks out from underneath of her, you know, after she hatches them. I mean, like, I might give her a day with the chickens, but then I'm going to bring them inside, and it's going to be during the warm season, but I'm not going to let her raise any more chickens because I can't handle the stress of trying to figure out where to put them. I mean, basically, you really should have a separate area for mama and hens. I did kind of have that. It was sort of a hybrid thing. Luckily, the rest of the flock treated those chickens pretty well. But so next time I hatch out chicks, it's either going to be in an incubator, or if Miss Press goes broody during the warm season, I'll let her set on the eggs, hatch them out, and then I will brood them myself. Anyhow, so yeah, there's a few more things that I've done. I think this video is long enough. We'll go ahead and show those to you in the next video. Anyways, thanks for listening. Listening to me ramble. That's all I got for you guys today. See you in the next video. For watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.